Hi guys, we are on. This is SimSeniors, the Sunday afternoon endurance race. We're on Silverstone. I'd meant to do the same race last night, but I got the time wrong. It started at 7, but I thought it was 8, so by the time I got there, the race was coming to an end, so I made it today. Just finishing qualifying now, managed to 158.8, I'm in the Aston. Because our league starts tomorrow, I'm meant to be taking the Honda. Not sure if I might take the Aston because there's a couple of places I'm having trouble, like a Rouge in the Honda, and I'm having trouble on Paul Ricard as well at the end of the main straight. So I might, I've got, you know, a couple of hours or whatever to decide. I might jump back to the Aston for the league and then use the Honda for all the other races so I can get used to it a bit more and messing with the setup, because I can't seem to get it. Eau Rouge is terrifying. You can do it flat out, but if you get it just wrong by a fraction of an inch, you know, it kills you. So we'll see. Maybe the BM was the other option, but I think I get bored of it. The only thing I do like a lot about the BM is how the force feedback feels. I think it feels really good, better than a lot of the other cars. But other than that, I think I'd get bored. It's quite a kind of a numb car to drive. So at least with the Aston, it sounds good, and I've driven this probably more than any other car, as far as I know. We're just waiting to start the race. It's 1 hour long, one mandatory pit stop, taking 55 litres and then refuelling for 55. So 110 should be more than enough, but I'll add a few extra litres if it looks like it needs it. So there we go, pole position. It's not often I manage that. Yeah, I haven't been in the Aston for quite a while, and I jumped in and straight away I'm about half a second quicker than I am with the Honda, and I thought, wow, that's didn't expect it. So yeah, we'll see if it holds up for the race. Fingers crossed. We're just waiting for it to restart now.
Snuck that one in at the end, in Lee. Well done, mate.
Right. No pressure or nothing.
I was 0.3 up, and I got. Just went a bit wide and invalidated me last lap. I couldn't believe it.
I'm surprised I put it together, to be honest. It's always a nightmare track for me, this one.
Have you noticed there's five different cars in the top five? That's interesting.
That's a first.
Yeah.
Yeah, that is a first.
Yeah, but it's top four and then best of the rest, isn't it? You're way ahead.
Chris has replied to him, Giovanni, he must be a new guy.
I don't even know what's going on. I was doing better practice a while ago. I can't even get the car to stay on the track.
Good luck, everybody.
Yeah, good luck.
Yeah, good luck.
I need more than luck. Somebody say a prayer for me.
All
30 seconds till we start the engine. It's quite scary starting in pole position because you feel like you got a target on your back. It's like when you're sunbathing and you're lying on your stomach.
14 the race today. Happy days.
You're getting murdered by the sun.
I just keep it clean.
Okay. Here we go.
30 seconds.
Good luck, everybody.
Good luck. You too, mate.
Yep, good luck, everyone. Have a good one.
Yeah, good luck.
Okay. Quite nervous, actually. My stomach's doing... still looks like a washing machine.
Are you cold?
Going double file.
Picking your tail.
There we go. I remember the Aston's first gear is pretty long, so it kind of bogs a bit.
This is going to be tight.
No.
Yep. Sorry, Colin, we exchanged pint there.
That's all right.
Good. Sorry, I was in unsafe. Christ, I'm weird. Do you have any damage, Colin?
Not sure. I think so.
Got the jar respray too.
Going through then. Thank you.
almighty. Sharpens heavy.
Do the slipstream again.
Thank you. Jesus. Sorry, dude, sorry. You joking?
I don't think John's on chat, you.
Oh, I went into a bit fast and lost it. Got very red tyres at the moment.
slipstream now. Switch back.
Car on the right. Clear on the right.
It's got an off track.
A lot of oversteer. Oh, sorry, understeer.
bit more pressure on the front right. Tires are pulled. Yeah, my tires are starting to go now. Yeah. orders. Oh, it's there. Oh, I thought someone had taken it out, so you can floor it up to about here. But, anyway. Don't know where I'm stopping. Ooh, straight up. Wasn't sure for a minute then. Right, ignition on. Fan on. Whew. That was intense. So we're going to come out with about 26 minutes left. 53 litres. So far, so good. Three. Two, one. There we go.
Mandatory stop is now clear. Come on, go, go, go.
Felt alright, apart from the slow entry, but I suppose it's better than speeding in the pits. Okay. Ooh, fresh tyres. Ali, the guy that we were battling with at the start, I'm sure we had a speed in the pits thing. I was really enjoying that battle. Two up ahead are in the pit now. I think. Oh.
Car on the right. Clear on the right.
Oh, warning.
Warning for exceeding track limits.
Okay, back marker. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
This is quick in that Ferrari. Can't pull away. I'm moving my tyres because they've still got to last a while yet. Pressures are perfect after that little squeak. rest of that slidey. Tyre's a bit hot there. Have a battle on our hands.
What the fuck?
Yellow flag in sector 2.
What happened, Melon?
Dude, my car just slipped. My car's dead. What? Sorry, guys.
What the fuck? What?
Brakes good on full. The brake, my brake is just going on full. Full lock.
The pedal failed.
Thank you.
my brakes are fucked.
Can anyone hear me on Discord?
Holy shit.
I think I've just lost Discord. Back to Discord again. That was weird. My eyes are starting to feel a little mushy.
Thank you.
last corner there. Getting some understeer now. Bad exit. Well, I think he must have had a bad exit as well. More lap, I think. Thank you. corners.
Close at the front.
Bloody hell, wasn't it just? I'm knackered.
0.3.
And it was about that for the whole race.
And there's Charles, the guy in second, saying he should be in group two because he's only new.
Nice try.
Right.
No, he's definitely, he's quick on, I saw him on another track the other day and he was quick on that as well. So definitely.
Mr. Starkey catch me all the way through. I was like, no.
At the beginning, I just couldn't seem to get it under 7 seconds. And it was like, once it did, it seemed to drop down quite quick.
Yeah, it was. It stayed at 7. And I was thinking, keep it at that. Don't do anything silly. And then I made small errors. And I was like, starting to tense. I'm like, no, don't do this.
Yeah, overdriving it a little bit. I think that's what I kept doing, trying to push to catch you.
Yeah, I was hoping you were, and that your tyres had run out, to be fair.
Yeah, they were screaming a bit.
Yeah, mine were at the end. I thought, oh, well, I've got to push.
I'm not overly sure what happened when I spun. I must have... Normally, I just lift off and change down gear, going through Maggots and Beckett's on that first right, and then hit the brakes, but... it wouldn't change down, so I'm like, oh, I must be going too quick here. I didn't want to touch my brakes because I knew I was going to spin after that, but I obviously didn't have much choice.
Yeah, I must admit, I was like, oh, someone got off there. And when I come through there, I come through the first one in fifth and then just double shift down to third.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. My tyres were literally red. My left-hand tyres were red. After that spin.
Mine were yellow all the way through. I kept thinking, oh god, these aren't going to last long.
I was hoping to try and keep up with you today, Dan, but we lost it trying to keep up.
you were right there for ages, and then I don't know, a few laps went past, I forgot to check my mirror, and then I thought, hang on, someone else is there now, where'd he go?
Yeah, I lost it at Maggots and Beckett's. Went in too hot and couldn't change down gear enough. I didn't want to touch the brakes.
Yeah.
Because I knew what was going to happen. But if I didn't, I'd have gone straight on and into the side of you. So missed the brake.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, I'm not sure what happened to Lee, but he
got a drive or stop and go, I think, from his pit stop.
Was it speeding in the pit? Was it?
Yes. Typical bit me on a pit stop again. I didn't turn my engine off, so I'm sat there thinking, why aren't they working on my car?
Oh, no.
Turn my engine off. Finally did it. And then I think it might have been because I had my gloves on and I didn't press the keyboard to turn the engine off properly. So it's purely my fault, self-inflicted. So then when I left the pits, I went like a scalded rabbit, didn't I? And then got done for speeding.
Because the pit entry was scary, because I thought, hang on, I've not practiced this. And I thought, where are the speed markers? So I slowed down way too early because I thought maybe the boards have been taken out or something. And I thought maybe that's how you got one at the start or something.
This track, it's always self-inflicted on this track. I always do something stupid.
That's why I didn't pick the Honda.
Good while it lasted to begin with, to be fair. That was a cracking start. That
it was.
Really
that,
good.
That was a great battle. Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah, good fun again, that chaps tonight. Good fun.
Yeah, always enjoy that.
You all set for Monday, Tuesday?
Yeah, Colin, is it possible for me to change to the Aston before tomorrow?
If you want to, I can swap over. It only takes a minute or two.
Yeah, no, please. It's just I can't do a Rouge in the Honda. I keep trying it, but I just keep losing it. And with that being the longest race at the end... And I just have a horrible feeling I'm just going to end up murdering somebody with me.
I'll change it right now.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, great stuff. At least I know this car, and I'll practice with the Honda in between to try and make it me main eventually.
At least if you're in the Aston off the line at the grid, I've got a chance of keeping up with you.
Yeah, that's the only downside. It's that long first gear is very bogs down quite a bit.
Yeah. Everything else just seems to blast away from me, but the Aston.
Yeah.
keep up with off the line.
Right, Dan, that's you in the Aston Martin Vantage V12.
I used to love driving that because of how it sounds.
Does sound good.
It does. It's like an F1 car, isn't it?
Oh. Yeah, so just make sure tomorrow you turn up in the Aston and not the Honda.
Yeah, no worries, mate. Right, I'm going to go get something to eat and go to the toilet.
Yep, nice one, guys.
All right, chaps, catch you all later.
All right, cheers, guys. Thanks, bye. See you tomorrow. Bye. There we go. So, a purple lap and a win. Doesn't often happen, that. Not sure why the Discord decided to not unmute me when out, because I wanted to say thanks to the back marker that let me by, but it wouldn't unmute. And then about 5 minutes later, it did about 10 different actions because I'd been pressing it over and over and not working. So at least I think that was a Discord thing. Right. Ooh, quite knackered after that now. Okay, so tomorrow we're in the Aston and it is on KL Army. We're in Group A, so it's all of the SimSeniors groups, fastest drivers tomorrow, and then Group 2 is on a Tuesday. So I think there's meant to be 32 of us in each one. I think that was the number. And there's no way I'm going to be winning or anything, because some of the fastest guys, they weren't racing tonight. And, but I'll do my best. I'll push my best again, so I'll do some practice tomorrow. So, right. Go and get some food. So, thank you for watching. See you tomorrow. Bye.